The new vehicle scrappage policy, unveiled by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on August 13, aimed at recycling old and unfit vehicles, is expected to draw investments of around 10,000 crore rupees and give impetus to circular economy. Here is what the policy entails. The much-awaited vehicle scrappage policy was launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on August 13 during his virtual address at the Investor Summit in Gujarat. Modi said the Voluntary Vehicle Fleet Modernization Program, also known as the Automobile Scrappage Policy, is expected to generate investments of around 10,000 crore rupees. He also added that the incumbent method of scrapping of materials was not productive. Union Minister for Road Transport and Highways, Nitin Gadkari, who was also present at the event where Modi launched the new policy, said the move is likely to lead to a cut in raw material costs by around 40%. As the government rolls out the new vehicle scrappage program, here is an explainer on what the policy entails. What does the policy aim to achieve? The idea is to phase out cars which are older than 20 and commercial vehicles which are older than 15 years. This means that any private vehicle that's older than 20 years will have to undergo a fitness test. A fitness test, according to the finance minister, will be conducted at automated fitness centers, which will determine whether the vehicle in question is qualified to run on roads or headed for the scrap heap. How does fitness test work? According to the new policy guidelines, a vehicle will have to undergo a fitness test after the accepted 20-year period. While it's possible for the car to pass a fitness test and acquire a fitness certificate, each fitness test would cost approximately 40,000 rupees. This is in addition to the road tax and possible green tax that you have to pay while mandatorily renewing your private vehicle's registration after the 15-year period. Each fitness certificate is applicable for 5 years, after which the owner of the vehicle will be required to get another fitness test costing the same. The financial cost of keeping a car in road-ready shape alone would then discourage the owner from constantly renewing the certificate. Are there any other costs involved? Yes. The government has proposed a green tax which requires you to pay 10 to 25% of your road tax every time you renew your fitness certificate. This means that in addition to the fee you're required to shell out for the test, you have to pay a considerable sum which differs from city to city based on their pollution levels. In the Delhi NCR region, for example, the green tax, if implemented, would require the customer to pay 50% of the road tax upon renewal of registration. What happens if your vehicle does not pass the fitness test? According to the law, it is illegal to drive a car that hasn't passed a fitness test as it is considered unregistered. One cannot cheat a fitness test while going through the mandatory re-registration process, and if the vehicle fails the test, it is simply not registered, making it illegal to drive it on the road. The policy, which will be in effect from April 1, 2022, would also offer a monetary incentive to the owners sending their vehicles to the scrap heap, although if the vehicle fails the fitness test thrice, they wouldn't be left with much of a choice. More details, such as the setting up scrappage docks and yards, are awaited. Under the proposed policy, over 51 lakh vehicles, both private and commercial, are over 20 years old. Their removal from the roads will not only urge their owners to buy new vehicles and possibly adopt newer technologies like EVs, it will also help bring down vehicular pollution by an estimated 25%.